We're the Cars. I'm Bob.
And I'm Jan.
They were mainstays of the midday.
This is Bob.
And this is Jan. And
Bob and Jan Carr, staples of WDSU TV in the 60s.
We had quite a time, too, last night on Halloween.
We did an audition for them, and they said, sold. We're opening the Royal Orleans Hotel. You guys go upstairs and put on a show.
And boy, did they. The couple welcomed into homes across Louisiana for roughly a decade.
We were on sometimes 7 days a week because we did our second cup show, then the midday show, then the Bob and Jan show. Remember Hammer, Nail, and...
Screw.
Not just fixtures and entertainment, but also breaking barriers.
Husbands and wives are not supposed to work together at the station. I thought that's kind of silly. Catholic towns, husband and wife can't work together. When they hired Bob and Jan, I mean, it's Bob and Jan. It's not Bob or Jan. It's Bob and Jan, okay?
They even had to get special permission from station management and the Monsignor.
We were the first husband and wife team, so we kind of represented the family of...
Image
of New Orleans.
That family also grew on air as Jan kept working while pregnant.
She had an aunt back in West Virginia and said, that's disgusting. Disgusting to see Janet pregnant on television. Well, that's the way it was in those days.
Yeah.
How did you feel about that?
Oh, I just ignored them. They weren't going to stop me.
That's right.
With many of their children featured in WDSU commercials, even playing behind the scenes while they did TV or radio shows, the dynamic duo put a focus on family and community, even acting as activists while living in the French Quarter.
We were adamant about saving the quarter from being destroyed by an interstate highway going across Jackson Square.
They fought desperately as part of the Save Our Square campaign, SOS.
And they listened.
And they listened, and it was defeated.
Even now, the Cars are still making their voices heard.
Hi, welcome to the program. I'm Bob.
And I'm Jan.
Producing and hosting their own show about their Christwood retirement community.
We talk about the different people here. We talk about how maybe we have to use a little marijuana to get ourselves up. But it works for some of us. It doesn't work for others.
And at 95 and almost 92 years old, the couple is about to celebrate their 71st wedding anniversary.
We're going to stick together, but it kills us.
You know what?
And it's that attitude they want to leave with listeners and those also wanting to break barriers.
Just be yourself.
And persevere.
Mm-hmm. Randy Russo, WDSU News.